Welcome back to the PI WebParts 2013 SP1 installation video series. In the previous video, we installed and deployed the PI WebParts SharePoint solution. In this video, we're going to be installing the PI WebParts services. Before you install the PI WebParts services, you first have to make sure there is a website available to install the services to. In order to make sure you have one available, you will want to open up your IIS manager. If you expand Sterling and sites, you will see the sites you have available. When you are installing PI WebParts services, you want to make sure you do not install it to the SharePoint site. This will create issues later on during the configuration. So you're going to want to install it to a site that is not the SharePoint one. We can install it to the default website that is already there, but I'm going to create a new site for PI WebParts services. In order to do that, you right-click Sites and do Add Website. Just give it a name. I'm going to call it PI WebParts. You have to give it a physical path. So I'm just going to do a Browse. I'm going to go to inetpub. I'm actually going to right click and create a new folder. Call it PI WebParts. And select OK. You also want to change the port. You cannot have two websites with the same port running at the same time. So I'm just going to change the port number to 888. And then once you have that configured, you can just select OK. And you'll see the site appear. We now have a site to install PI WebParts services to. So once you have a site available, or once you've created a new site, you can start the installation. We will run the same installation kit we did when we installed the PI WebParts solution. Again, I'll run as an administrator. Unzip it to the default location. And we will see the same pop-up that we saw before. The solution is already installed, so I'm going to uncheck that one and just check PI WebParts services and then select continue. And you'll see a new window pop up saying what it's going to install with the PI WebParts services. You can see it needs a few other components like the SDK, some OLEDB, but just select OK and we'll go through the installation. The first thing it installs is the PI SDK. It's asking where I would like to install it. I'm going to keep the default location, which is C, Program Files, x86, PI PC. You may want to change this if you have another drive installed to something like D, Program Files, x86, PI PC. But I'm just going to keep the default. It's then going to ask for a default PI server. I'm just going to use the PI server we're going to connect to with PI WebParts. It's called JGALG, J-G-A-L-G, and then just select Next. And then it just gives you a little overview, and I'm going to install the 32-bit PI SDK. Now it's going to install a 64-bit PI SDK. Next is the PI AF client. This is going to ask you for a default AF server. And my AF server is on the same machine as my PI server, so I'm just going to type JGALG in and select Next. This will tell you what components of the PI AF client is going to install. And you'll actually see one part is not installed, the Analysis Management plugin. You also see it's not going to install PI Builder. This is because that is a plugin to Excel, and I do not have Microsoft Excel installed on this computer. You'll see it has to stop an application. I'll just do that automatically. Finally, we're going to install the PI WebParts Services. You'll see this is where we selected the website to install it to. Again, you cannot install it to the SharePoint website, so I'm going to select the website we created earlier in the video, PI WebParts. Just select Next. Then it's going to ask you what PI server you want it to store the PI WebParts configuration. I'll again use JGalc. And next is going to ask which SharePoint server host or farm name we're going to connect to with this PI WebParts Services. The SharePoint server is on the same machine, in this case, as PI WebParts Services, so I'll just type in Sterling. And finally, it'll begin the installation of PI WebParts Services. And with that, we've completed the installation of PI WebParts Services. You'll see it has to update the PI WebParts solution. And you can see that after it updates the PI WebParts solution, the setup is finished. Then we can have the installation kit take us to the SharePoint administration site, but I'm just going to close it out. Once you've completed installing the PI WebParts Services, it is a good idea to check out your application pools. If you open up IIS Manager and just browse your computer, you'll see application pools. There are two new ones. One is called PI WebParts. This one was created when we created the PI WebParts website. And another called PI WebParts Services, which was created when we ran the installation kit. The identity that the PI WebParts Services application pool is using needs read access to both the PI server and the AS server. For the PI server, you can grant it read access through the recommended PI mappings or PI trust. But the AF server uses the Active Directory, so you need to make sure that the user that this application pool is using has access to the AF server. To change the identity, you can click Advanced Settings over here on the right, or you can right-click and select Advanced Settings. Then under the Advanced Settings, you'll see one that's called Identity, and you can just select the ellipsis to change the identity it's going to use. I'm going to use a custom account because I've created a service account to run this application pool. And you can see, once I select OK, that the identity has changed. Select OK, and you'll see it in IIS here as well. So now, my PI WebParts Services application pool is using this service account that I've created, and I'm going to have to give that service account the correct permissions to both my PI server and my AF server, which I'll do later on. That's all you have to do to install the PI WebParts Services. In the next video, I will talk about configuring PI WebParts.